A warm welcome to all the viewers for the course Strength of Materials. Myself Thea Pal, Assistant Professor of Department of Mechanical Engineering, JIS College of Engineering. And today in this particular lecture, I am going to deliver module 1, that is of the body where we are going to produce the heat and we are going to obtain the thermal stresses and strain. So today in this particular lecture, we are going to cover up the entire ocean, that how this thermal or the temperature is basically inducing the stresses and strain in the composite bar or in any sort of bar or in any sort of material. So thermal stresses and strain, as you know, that what is stress and strain? Stress means you are giving load per unit area, and strain means you are just changing the length by its original length. Now all this stress and strain, whatever if we are discussing, it is also associated with modulus of elasticity. And what is that? Why? Or in fact, we can change the strain when we are finding out there is a relationship between strain, stress and modulus of elasticity. And another law that is coming in our mind, that is the Hooke's law, that stress is proportional to the strain within your elastic limit. So in this particular module 1, we have already came across various concepts regarding the implementation of the load in the composite bar through the axial way or axial loading. Again, we have also studied the deflection or the change in length due to the own weight of the bar, as well as we have also came across if we are having a taper section and then also we are implementing the some load, then what will be the change in length that is occurring. So these are the various things that we have already studied and we came across. But today this lecture is consisting of something different. What is the different? That is, we are going to make or consider a bar, we are going to produce some heat over it, or we are going to provide some heat over the bar, and what we are getting ultimate, we are obtaining the thermal stress and strain in that particular body. So before we start the lecture, let's have a look at the content. Initially, we are talking about the contents. So first, we are going to have just a simple introduction. Second, we will be studying about the thermal stresses in simple bar. Third, we are going to discuss the thermal stresses in the bar if it is a circular tapering section. Then we will be talking about the thermal stresses in the bar or bearing section. We'll be discussing the thermal stresses in composite bar. And last, we will be discussing about the superposition of your thermal stresses. And finally, we are going to solve out some numerical. So today's lecture basically consists of the following parameter. Initially, we'll be starting with the introduction. Then we'll be moving for the thermal stresses that is obtained in a simple bar. Again, we are going to consider the thermal stresses in the bar if it is having a circular taper section. We will be discussing of the thermal stresses in the bar or bearing section. We'll be considering thermal stresses in composite bar. We'll be discussing the superposition of thermal stresses as well as all the numericals. So without any further delay, let's have a look at the introduction. So introduction, in this introduction, what we will be getting, let's have a look here. Now, for a long time, it has been established that whenever there is some sort of increase or decrease in the temperature of a body, it causes the body to expand or contract. Again, I am repeating, just have a look. That is, for a long time, whenever there is some sort of increase or decrease in temperature of a body, it basically causes the body to expand or contract. Now, if you consider a little bit, or if you think a little consideration, if you take in this particular cases, what it will show? It will show that if the body is allowed to expand or contract freely with the raise of or fall of temperature, then no stresses are induced in the body. But if the deformation of the body is prevented, then obviously some sort of stresses will be induced in the body. And such stresses is known as your thermal stresses, or it is known as temperature stresses. So if you have a look at this particular entire introduction of today's lecture, then it is just telling us one thing, that when you are implementing some sort of temperature to any sort of body, then obviously it try to get expand or it try to get contract. Means if you remove the temperature, it will always try to contract because due to the solidification. So what I was talking is that whenever we have studied and whenever we have make a consideration related to thermal as well as thermal stress and strain, it is not today matter. It is a long study where we have seen that due to some increase or decrease in temperature, the body always expand and contract. This is a very basic concept. Along with that, if the body is allowed to expand and contract along with the influence of temperature, then I must say that there will be no stresses that will be induced in the body. But due to this temperature, if you are not allowing the body to get deformed, or you are preventing any sort of deformation in the body, obviously stresses will be introduced in the body. And such type of stresses are known as thermal stresses, or it is known as temperature stresses. And the corresponding strain that has been introduced due to this, this prevention, it is known as your thermal strain, or it is known as temperature strain. So we have studied that stress is proportional to strain. If it is within elastic limit, then it is defining the Hooke's law. So in the similar manner, if I talk about the introduction of the thermal stresses and strain, the very basic thing that has been told to us, it is just if you allow the body to get expanded or it is contracted due to the implementation of your temperature, then obviously no stresses will be induced in the body. But if you prevent the body to be getting deformed, or if you are preventing the deformation that has been induced in the body, then there is a high chance of getting stress induced in that particular body. And this type of stresses is known as thermal stresses or temperature stresses. And the strain corresponding to the stress, that is change in length to the original length or change in diameter to the original diameter, it's also known as thermal strain or temperature strain. Now let's move to the next slide. So now we will be considering one of the cases, that is the thermal stresses in your simple bar. So in a simple bar, what it has been told is that whatever the thermal stresses or strain in a simple bar you consider, you have to discuss some sort of thing or some sort of parameters you have to keep in the mind. What is that? First one, you need to calculate the amount of deformation that is occurring due to the change of temperature with the assumption that the bar is free to expand or contract. So first you are calculating the amount of deformation, and that is also due to change of temperature, and that is also with the assumption that you are allowing the bar to expand and contract. So far we were discussing that if we are not allowing a bar to expand or contract, then obviously there will be stress will be induced. But here what we are talking? Here we are talking that we need to calculate the change in deformation due to change in temperature. Along with that, we are considering that we are allowing the bar to get expand and contract. So this case is very complicated when you are studying the thermal stresses in simple bar. Now, second point, it has been told you need to calculate the load or the force that is required to bring the deformed bar to the original length. So you need to calculate the load along with the force, and it is also required to bring the deformed bar to the original length. And finally, we are talking about, that is, calculate the stress and strain in the bar which is caused by this load. So we are calculating the load, or you can say we are calculating the force which is just required to bring the deformation of the bar to the original length. So deformation is occurring. And third point, you need to calculate the stress and strain due to the implementation of this type of load. So you can see the three objective of the thermal stresses in simple bar is as simple as it is. First of all, you need to calculate the deformation due to the change of temperature. Along with that, you need to know that the assumption is that bar is freely allowed to expand or contract. Second is calculation of the load is required that should be there to bring the load deformation of the bar to the original length. And finally, third is that calculating the stress and strain in the bar which is caused by this load. Now, the thermal stresses or strain may be also found at first by finding out the amount of deformation due to change in temperature, and then by finding out the thermal strain due to deformation. So the thermal stress may now be found out from the thermal strain as usual, but you need to consider a body and it has to be subjected to an increase in temperature. So you have to select a body, along with that you need to increase your temperature so that you can get the thermal stress along with the thermal strain. That is the main objective of today's study. So now we'll move to the next slide. So what we are doing is there, initially we are considering a length as L, that is the original length of a body. Along with that, we have considered the increase in temperature as T. Alpha is your coefficient of linear expansion. So before we are discussing the entire thing, few things you have to keep in mind, that is the annotation. Small L denotes the original length of the body. Small t denotes the increase of temperature. Alpha denotes the coefficient of linear expansion. So if you increase the length, or you can say the change in length that is occurring due to increase in temperature, and it is represented by del L, then I must say del L is equal to L into alpha into T. So this thing you have to keep in mind, that is del L is equal to L into alpha into T. And if the end of the bar is fixed, now just have a look at this condition. So far we were thinking that it was free, but no, now we are having two fixed support, or we are keeping the bar under two fixed to rigid support. That means if the end of the bar are fixed to rigid support, so that you are preventing the expansion. So when you are preventing the expansion, then obviously compressive strain is induced in the bar. Am I clear? If you consider a bar and if the ends of the bar are fixed to the rigid supports, then I must say the expansion is prevented. And if your expansion is prevented, that means obviously the compressive strain is inducing in that bar. So in that case, if I ask you what is strain, obviously you will tell change in length by your original length. And what is the value for your change in length? L into alpha into T. So that thing only has been done here. That thing has been only done here. And you can see del L by L, and you know the value for del L, that is L into alpha into T by your original length, that is L. So finally what you get the value of strain is none other than alpha T. None other than alpha T. Now if I ask you what is stress, then you will be saying that if you multiply the strain into your modulus of elasticity, then you are getting the stress, because modulus of elasticity is stress by strain. So strain value you have achieved for thermal stresses in simple bar, it is alpha t, and you know the value for modulus of elasticity, that is represented by E. So now if I ask you what is stress, then very easily you are going to define me, that is the value is A into T into E. Okay, A into T into E. Fine. Now you have to keep in mind, if the support yield by an amount which is equal to delta, then what is the actual expansion that has been taken here? So del L is equal to what? L into alpha into T minus your del. And if you need to calculate the strain, then strain is formed by the formation, that is alpha T into del L. Now if I ask you to say what is the stress, then you are going to define me that stress is none other than strain into modulus of elasticity, and that is only defining you what, that is alpha into T minus del by L into E. So this is the combined thermal stresses that is occurring in your simple bar. So from this particular point of view, you can see that first of all we are finding out the increase in length, then we are considering that the end of the bar should be fixed, I mean to say rigidly supported, so that expansion is prevented. And if expansion is prevented, then obviously compressive strain is being induced in the bar, and that has been defined as alpha T. Now stress is equal to what? Your sigma, that is equal to strain into E is equal to alpha T E. Del L value has been also calculated, and you have seen the value for stress also. Stress is equal to your strain into modulus of elasticity. Now let's move to the next slide. So in this portion we are going to study a numerical. So in this numerical we have considered an aluminium alloy bar which has been fixed at its both end through 20 Kelvin. That means you are heating the temperature at 20 Kelvin. Okay, fine. And find the stress that has been developed in the bar. You have to consider the modulus of elasticity as 80 gigapascal and coefficient of linear expansion of the bar material as 24 into 10 to the power 6 per Kelvin respectively. Now according to the formula, you are very aware that stress that has been developed, it is represented by alpha TE. So alpha means your coefficient of your linear expansion. So you put the value of alpha, that is 24 into 10 to the power minus 6, into your temperature, that is your 20 Kelvin, into your modulus of elasticity, that is your 80 gigapascal, or you can write 80 into 10 to the power 3 newton per millimeter squared. So finally the value what you have achieved is 38.4 newton per millimeter squared. Now newton per millimeter squared is also represented as megapascal. So if it has been asked to you what is the thermal stress developed in the bar, it is 38.4 megapascal. As you can see, 38.4 megapascal. Now let's move to the next slide. This is the second numerical where it has been told that two parallel valves, that is of 6 meter apart, are stayed together by a steel rod. So you are having two parallel valves and they are apart from each other by 6 meter, and there is a steel rod in between them having a diameter of 25 millimeter, and that is passing through the metal plate and nuts at each other. Now the nuts have been tightened home when the rod is at a temperature of 100 degrees Celsius. You need to determine the stresses that has been induced in the rod, and you have to calculate when the temperature falls down to 60 degrees Celsius. So first condition is if the ends do not yield, and the second condition is the ends yield by 1 millimeter. So solution is very simple. First of all, we need to calculate the stresses in the rod when there is no yielding. So formula is same. Stress is equal to alpha into T into E. Okay, so alpha value has been provided to you, 12 into 10 to the power minus 6, along with the temperature 40, along with the modulus of elasticity as 200 into 10 to the power cube. Finally, you have achieved the result, that is 96 megapascal. And next, it has been told that if the body means the stress in the rod, you need to find out when the ends will yield by 1 millimeter. So there is a yielding is occurring. And what is that? The formula will be represented by, in that particular case, is pi 2 is equal to alpha t minus del by L into E. So alpha is what? 12 into 10 to the power minus 6 into your temperature 40 minus your del L by L, that is this del L is what? That is your yielding by 1 millimeter. That's only written here. See, 1 millimeter has been given here. This is your actually yielding point that is occurring by 1 millimeter by 60 into 10 to the power 3, because this is the total length that has been considered. And you, a modulus of elasticity has been given, that is 200 into 10 to the power 3 newton per millimeter square. So finally, you have achieved the stress in the rod when ends yielding by 1 millimeter, that is 62.6 megapascal. So this is the entire concept that has been provided here. Okay. The next portion we came here, it is all about the thermal stresses that has been occurred in a circular tapering section. So if you have a look at this particular thing, you have got a taper bar. This is D1 is the diameter at the bigger end of the bar, and D2 is the diameter of the smaller end of the bar. And the entire length has been considered as L, and T is the increase in temperature, and alpha is as usual coefficient of your linear expansion. So next we are talking about the thermal stresses in the bar of a circular tapering section. And what we have studied is that we know that as a result of increase in temperature, obviously the bar AB will tends to expand. But since it is fixed at both the end, therefore it will cause some sort of compressive stress. And all of you know that del L is equal to L into alpha into T. And P is your load that has been implemented in the body to be get deformed from its original length. So if you consider that the bar is having two end fixed and compressive stress is occurring, that means there will be a reduce in the length due to this compressive stress. So your change in length for this particular portion, it is none other than what? Del L is equal to 4PL into pi into E into D1 into D2. Okay. And if you solve this equation, this del L is equal to L into alpha T. Again, del L for the taper section bar that we have calculated for the change in length due to the taper section, we have studied, that is 4PL by pi E into D1 into D2. Now you equate this two equation. So when you will equate this two equation, what value you are getting for the P? That is pi into E into D1 into D2 into alpha T by 4. And if you go with the maximum stress, that is the maximum stress that has been induced here, it is none other than alpha T into E into D1 by D2. So note, if we substitute D1 is equal to D2, then the above relationship is reduced to, that is, stress is equal to alpha into T into E. Because if D1 is equal to D2, for simple bar, if we substitute, then this D1 and D2 both will be getting omitted. So when both of them will be getting omitted, then you what you will be having, that is sigma is equal to alpha into T into E. So this is the final thing that you will be achieving. Now we are discussing about the thermal stresses if we are considering a bar of varying section. So this is another case. So far we have considered the taper. Now we'll be discussing the bar of varying section. So this is bar number 1. If you consider this as to be bar number 1 and this has to be bar number 2, then you can see AB is a bar of having length L1 and BC is the bar 2 having length L2. So these both are having various section and you can see both are fixed. So same thing here also we will be considering, but there we have considered a taper section, but here we are considering a simple bar of varying section. That means it has got various diameter, various length, and we are considering how to calculate the thermal stress that has been induced in the bar. So initially let us consider, that is length L1, it is the length of portion AB of the bar. So the stress that has been induced in the AB portion will be denoted by sigma 1. And if I ask you what is the area of the bar AB, then it will be considered as A1. Similar manner, you consider L2 as the corresponding value for the length for bar BC. Sigma 2 as the stress that has been induced in the bar BC, as well as A2 is the area of the cross section of the bar BC. So these are the corresponding value for the portion BC. Finally, we are considering alpha as a coefficient of linear expansion, and as usual we will be considering T as the increase in temperature. So one thing you have to do is that you have to remember the notation, because with this notation we are going to deduce the formula. Now let's move to the next slide. So basically we know that with the increase in temperature, the bar ABC will tends to expand. It is a very simple thing, because when you are heating a bar, obviously it will try to expand. But as I have already told, that in this particular bar, you have seen that we have made A and C as fixed. So if A and C is fixed, then obviously it will experience some sort of compressive stress in the body, because it is not able to getting expand. So when it is not able to get any sort of expand and it is fixed at both the end and you are inducing the temperature, then obviously a compressive stress will be occurring at the both of the end. So normally the stress that has been induced in the both the portion, both are equal. So you know that both are equal, that means sigma 1 A1 is equal to sigma 2 A2. So the thermal stress that is inducing in the body for AB, or you may consider for BC, in both the cases the thermal stresses are equal. That is sigma 1 into A1 is equal to sigma 2 into A2. Now if you consider the change in length, or if you consider the total deformation in the body, then what will be its formula? That is the deformation that is occurring in the bar 1 plus the deformation occurring in the bar 2. This both will give you the summation value for change in deformation of the entire bar. So when you are discussing about the change in length for bar 1, it is sigma 1 into L1 by E plus sigma 2 into L2 by E. So finally what you will get the value for del L, that is represented by L by E into sigma 1 into L1 plus sigma 2 into L2. Now one thing you have to keep in mind, that is the modulus of elasticity is different for different section of modulus. So in such cases your total deformation will be what? sigma 1 L1 by E1 plus sigma 2 into L2 by your E. So this thing you have to consider if you are considering the various types of different types of material. So if different types of material you are considering, then obviously there is a different type of modulus of elasticity. So this thing you have to remember in case of if you are using the various types of material which is holding various modulus of elasticity value. Now let's have a look for the numerical. For varying section, you can see these are the two bars, both ends are fixed, and you can see here it has been shown that you are considering a steel bar of ABC and is firmly held between the two rigid support A and C as shown in the figure. And what is told that find the stress that has been developed in the two portion of the body, and when it is heated through a 15 Kelvin, and you have to take the coefficient of linear expansion as 12 into 10 to the power minus 6 per Kelvin and modulus of elasticity as 200 gigapascal. So what is the solution you have got? That is, sigma 1 is the stress induced in the body AB, sigma 2 that is the stress induced in the body BC, and sigma 1 is none other than A2 by A1 into sigma 2, because this is basically sigma 1 by sigma 2 is equal to A2 by A1. So this is the formula that will be helping you to get the value for sigma 1 also in other respect. Now change in length, you know the total is del 1, del L1 plus del L2. So initially what you did is that del L formula is length into alpha into temperature that has been given. So you have got both the value for the change in length of both the bar. So finally you have got the value for your change in length of the entire bar. Now according to this that we are considering, the compressive force has been applied at A and C, which will help you to cause a contraction. And that's why we have got the change in length as 0.234, which is basically your contraction value of the length. So this has been represented by the formula, that is your change in length is equal to 1 by E into sigma 1 into L1 plus sigma 2 into L2. And from there you have got the value of this particular portion, that is the sigma 1. And if you solve out the equation of sigma 1 and sigma 2, then you are able to get the value for sigma 2 also and value for sigma 1 also. So this is the final answer that is required by this question. One is 30.2 megapascal, another is 45.3 megapascal. Now we are talking about the thermal stresses in composite bar. So we have came across a various thing. Now we'll be considering the composite bar. That means two different material have been compacted together. Just have a look at this particular figure, steel and bar. This is also steel and bar, and this is also steel and bar. But you see the load has been implemented in some different direction. So whenever there is some sort of increase or decrease in the temperature of the bar, which is consisting of two or different material, it may causes the bar to expand or contract. So these two bar initially state, you can see that are of same, but you are hitting, but they both have got different property to get expand or to get contract. Now on account of different coefficient of linear expansion, the two material do not expand or contract by the same amount, but expand or contract by different amount. Now if you consider a composite bar of two member, a bar of steel, another bar of brass, then let the bar be heated through the same temperature. And if the component member of the bar, steel and bar, could have been freely allowed to expand, then there will be no internal stress would be induced. But since the two members are rigidly fixed, therefore the composite bar as a whole will expand by the same amount. And we know that bar, brass expand more than the steel, because the coefficient of linear expansion of the bar is greater than that of steel. So therefore the free expansion of the brass will be more than that of the steel. That has been only shown here. Brass is getting expanded more than the steel. But since both the members are not free to expand, therefore the expansion of the composite bar as a whole will be less than that of brass, but more than that of steel. That has been shown in this figure. and it is thus obvious that the bar will be subjected to compressive force. Whereas, if you consider this bar, this has been considered to be compressive force. But if you consider the steel, it has been considered to be as tensile force. You can see by this arrow in figure number C. So what we were thinking, that is sigma 1 as stress in the bar, strain in the bar has been considered. Alpha 1 has been coefficient of linear expansion. In this way, we have considered the two different parameters. Next, you know what is the value, that is as compressive load on the bar, that is equal to the tensile load of the steel. That's why from there you can write sigma 1 A1 is equal to sigma 2 A2. And now strain in the bar, it has been represented by alpha into T into minus E. And strain in the steel is also represented by E2, that has been given as alpha 2 into T into E2. And adding this both the equation, the value that you get, that is minus T into alpha 1 plus alpha 2. And in the above equation, the value of alpha 1 is always taken greater for the two value of alpha 1 and alpha 2. So now let's have a look at the numerical, where you can see this three composite bar has been taken of a length of 200 millimeter into 220 millimeter into 8. As you can see, this is the composite bar, and here given the Young's modulus of the steel, Young's modulus of aluminium, coefficient of steel and coefficient of aluminium has been provided to you. And what you need to get, it is to find out the stresses that has been induced in the bar. And you can see the temperature has been raised to 50 degrees Celsius. Solution is very simple. You know, you need to find the area of the steel bar, you need to find out the area of the aluminium. Because it is of two bar you are using, that's why you have multiplied it two. And you know what is the formula for your stress for this particular thing, which is area of aluminium by area of steel into stress induced in aluminium. So after that, what you are doing is that strain you have calculated for steel, you have calculated the strain for aluminium, and you know the total strain is the summation of the strain that has been induced in steel and aluminium, which is represented by this formula, that is T into alpha A minus alpha S. And then you have achieved the formula and you have got the value for sigma A, and sigma A value you have got, and this after getting the value of sigma A, it is very easy to calculate the value for sigma S, because sigma S, that is stress induced for steel, is equal to 1.5 of stress induced in aluminium. So this is the answer that is required for your question. One is 30 megapascal, another is 45 megapascal. Now at the last we have came to a discussion, that is what is the superposition of thermal stresses. So in the last articles we have been discussing the thermal stresses in the bar, which are initially free to any type of tensile or compressive stresses, but sometime we come across a structure which are subjected to same loading before the their temperature is increased or decreased. So you are implementing same load, but the temperature may be increased or decreased. Such problems are solved in following two steps. First of all, what you have to do is that find out the stress that has been caused in it or in the member before they are changing its temperature. Second, you need to find out that the stress that has been occurred due to the change in temperature, and basically they uses the principle of superposition on the stress which has already obtained. And finally, the three is that is the two stresses that have been obtained above. Now such problems are very complicated and it needs lots of patience in knowing all type of stresses, that is whether it is tensile or compressive in both the cases. So superposition is none other than some sort of process to find out the thermal stresses, where you need to very assure about that you need to know about all this parameter. That is, you need to know about the stresses that is caused in the member due to the change in temperature. You need to calculate the stresses due to change in temperature, and that uses the principle of superposition on the stress. Again, you need to finally to find out the two above stresses that has been mentioned above. So finally, we came to the conclusion portion of this particular lecture. So from this today's lecture, hope all of you have able to understand that what are the stresses and strain that has been induced due to this temperature or due to this thermal. So if you are allowing it to expand and contract, then there will be no inducement of the stresses or strain. But if you are not allowing the bar to get expand or contract due to the change in temperature, then obviously some sort of stresses may occur in that body, and that type of stresses is known as thermal stress or temperature stress. And corresponding to that stress, the strain that has been generated, it is known as thermal strain as well as temperature strain. So thank you viewers for watching the video. So please stay connected with me, and if you have liked the video, then please subscribe my channel and like the video. And in the next lecture, we are going to discuss about the various principal plane, principal stresses, and obviously the Mohr cycle that is required to see where the stresses is occurring in which plane and so. Thank you viewers for watching the video. Thank you very much.